The bear markets are when legends are made. Ignoring the right tools during this time can keep you in the cold. And one of these tools is staking. But as we've learned recently, it's not quite as easy as people think. But with Ethereum, it is very easy. You just need 32 Ethereum and you get a validator node. But what if I told you there was an easy way to do this without having 32 ETH? It's called liquid staking. And Lido Finance is one of the best places where you can use liquid staking to grow your bags during this crypto winter. So to find out how that works and how you can get started, check out this video. Let's get it. Welcome to BitBoy Crypto. My name is Ben. Today we're going to be talking about Lido Finance. So let's get into the basics of Lido. So as you guys know, staking is live on Ethereum, but for the average person, 32 ETH, well, it's just too much. Most people don't have that much money sitting around to stake with and to create a validator node. You could use a centralized exchange, but as we've seen recently with Celsius and Voyager, that may not be the smartest idea. There are also protocols that pool people's Ethereum together to help them earn rewards without having to have 32 ETH. The rewards are then taken in by the liquid staker and dispersed to all the users on the network. And of course, how much you get is based upon how much ETH you stake. And of course, you do get charged a very small fee along the way, but see, the centralized exchanges, they're doing massive fees up to 25%. This is much smaller than that, and it's much safer. Lido Finance is currently the most popular on-chain, non-custodial option for staking. Many users prefer to use Lido because they don't have 32 ETH sitting around, or they don't have the technical knowledge on how to set up a node. So a little bit more about liquid staking. Lido users can put their money to work on other protocols while they're staking their ETH. And of course, that's thanks to the platform's LSD.
Now, don't trip. Calm down.
LSD stands for Liquid Staking Derivative. It's a synthetic version of Ether that users receive when they deposit their money into Lido. This means you can generate your rewards and take your synthetic ST ETH and do whatever you want with it. However, but you do need to remember that when you need to come unlock your stake, you need to return your ST ETH to the protocol. And if you lose that money on risky plays, hello Celsius, you will be unable to unlock your staked funds. You'll be stuck there forever. So how do you use the Lido protocol? So staking on Lido is surprisingly easy. Go to the Lido homepage, of course, make sure you typed in the proper URL. Don't ever Google these platforms and click on them because sometimes scammers use Google AdWords to put something at the top that looks like the platform you're looking for, but it's actually a scam. So make sure to be safe and don't ever give your private key away. Once you type in the right URL, you'll see a similar DeFi interface to what you're used to with other platforms you've used in the space. Here you connect your wallet and you put in the amount of ETH that you intend to stake. After that, all you do is click submit and wait for MetaMask, and boom, your transaction's confirmed. After that, your ETH will be staked and you can receive ST ETH in return. But be careful with that because like I said earlier, that is your key to unlocking your stake. Now, there has been some criticism around Lido Finance. Now, recently, Lido co-founder Vasily Shapovalov stirred up controversy, saying he thinks that businesses should be the ones to handle ETH staking. This is in direct opposition to the Ethereum community, who believes solo stakers should be the backbone of all ETH staking. Now, Shapovalov received a lot of criticism from many top devs, including Ben Edginton, who's extremely close to the development of the proof-of-stake network for Ethereum. Shapovalov actually ended up walking back those comments and insisted that Lido Finance is committed to building out their protocol to accommodate also solo stakers. But Lido Finance is not the only one in this game. While it may seem like the best option for non-custodial staking for Ethereum, there are a lot of challengers starting to catch up. Rocket Pool is another staking project that's showing a lot of promise right now. It's already live, plus it's more decentralized than a platform like Lido. The only problem is, Rocket Pool still requires a stake of 16 ETH, still more than most people can afford. Eventually, the minimum is going to drop down to 8 ETH. Yay! That's still more Ethereum than the average retail person owns. So this would not end up being a viable option for smaller stakers. But one thing is for sure, this idea that you can stake your ETH, receive ST ETH in return, and make returns on that while locking up your Ethereum, well, that sounds like to be a win-win as long as you're not doing super risky plays with it. So drop your comments below. Let me know what you think about Lido Finance and how to use it. Have you used it? What have your results been? Make sure to drop that down below. Love to hear your thoughts. That's all I got. Be blessed. BitBoy out.